Hello, my name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'm going to be using Sapphire for Photoshop to take our blank canvas and turn it into something much more interesting with our builder effects. Okay, so I'm in Photoshop with a completely blank canvas. It's 1920 by 1080 with just a background shape. And I'm going to make this a bit more interesting using Sapphire. Now, the first thing I always do is turn the layer that we're working on into a smart object. So I'm going to right click, convert to smart object. This means we have a lot more flexibility to play around with things at a later date. So let's come up to Filter, Boris Effects, Sapphire, and this will launch the effect builder. It always seems a bit intimidating when we start with a blank canvas, which is why Sapphire comes with so many presets. So I'm going to come up to the top and hit load to come into our preset browser. And I'm going to go straight over to Builder Effect, because these are the more complex effects that are built up out of more than one single filter. And we have almost 300 of these now. So I'm going to filter these a little bit more to see what we can do. So I'm going to click on my Add Filter, and I'm going to go down to the bottom and go to the Version Filters. So in 2020.5, we started bringing in version filters, and we can look at the newest presets just by clicking on 2022.5. And we have a good number of background presets. This has been a bit of a focus of the presets in this particular release. Now, if we were working in the video plugin version of Sapphire, we could see these backgrounds in motion. But we can't really do that in Photoshop because we're working on a still frame. So how do we come in and change these up? Well, let's take a look at Chrome Tentacles. This is a preset made by John Dickinson, and I'm just going to hit load. And this is going to load it up into the workspace, and we can see it's made up of quite a lot of different filters. And as I said, we don't actually have a way to change the frame on this. But there are different ways within the filter to move it forwards, of course. And when we're doing something like this, always start to look at the top effects first, because generally speaking, these are the places where the, you know, most of the groundwork is being done. If we look at black background, that's just a black background, so that's not very interesting. So let's move quickly onto texture neurons. And when we want to move something forward in time, my rule of thumb is to look for something that's called phase start. And if we take a little look down at our parameters here, we have one that's called phase start right here. And I can move this forwards and backwards. And I can get this sort of tentacle arm moving forwards and backwards as well. And if we want to change this in other ways, maybe we can have a look at things like morph X and Y, just to get a different look on there as well. And we can definitely see this is a chrome tentacle. And let's see how this works with something else as well. So if I load up another preset, come to my filters, go down to the version filters and go 2022.5. Let's take a look at something else. Maybe we'll take a look at the 80s glass warp background. Let's load that one in and let's look for the same thing. So I'm going to come up quite close to the top, and I have my gradient multi, which is just creating my colors, and I have my wave warps one here, and lo and behold, we have phase start and B phase start here. And if I change these up, we're starting to warp around a little bit, and we come down to the warp bubble, and instead of our morph, we have this thing called shift start, and we can just be playing around with that until we find the balance that we actually want here. And I'll hit OK on that, and that will just load that into Photoshop for me. So when we're looking to change how our backgrounds look in Photoshop, my top tips are: I start from the top of the node tree, look for something that's called phase start, and once you've got that in the right place, maybe work your way a little bit further down the tree, finding something that says shift XY or morph XY, and those are usually going to be the parameters that are going to create the biggest changes for you when you're wanting to move the backgrounds in time. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. I hope that's been helpful for you, and I look forward to seeing you in another Sapphire Photoshop tutorial in the very near future. Thanks for watching. To learn more about Sapphire for Photoshop or any of the Boris Effects products, head on over to borisfx.com, where you can find hours of free training and free trial versions of all of the software. And if you want to be one of the first to watch the new tutorials, remember to hit that subscribe button.